Chris, the name of the game for the Nets right now, find a way to win. They're playing without Kevin Durant, without James Harden. There are others that are missing in action right now for Brooklyn, taking on a shorthanded Boston team. And looked like the Nets were going to run away with it. Up 17, cruising towards the finish line. Something shifted. Celtics' great effort to make this one interesting. But in the end, the Nets made their free throws, came up with enough defensive stops to secure the W.
That was the key, Ian, the defensive stops. And yes, I think we saw throughout the course of this game some big-time shot-making by the Nets in certain areas. They did a tremendous job in dictating the tempo, pushing the pace. They had 32 fast break points, held Boston to none. But overall and ultimately, when they were closing out the game, it was about some timely stops, some blocks, some steals. So much of the activity and the reads on the defensive end allowed them to have those opportunities offensively, and everyone played a role. I think it's something that has become a theme with this team of different players stepping up and making contributions yep. throughout the course of the night. But you look across the board and think about some of those plays, whether it was Joe Harris knocking down a three-point shot, Bruce Brown with some big jams and dunks, Blake Griffin making plays, the list goes on. And for an off night for Kyrie Irving yep. from the field, was doing a lot of other little things and facilitating, getting the job done defensively. But just overall, a gritty way to close this one out when it did get tight.
Kyrie has taken on a lot of responsibility in the absence of Durant and James Harden, and not just the last few games, extended over a long period of time. The fact of the matter is that the Nets do have to find other ways if Kyrie just doesn't have it on a given night. You mentioned some of the players involved. Blake Griffin, one that really comes to mind, and the energy that he brought defensively. The hustle has been there from the day that he signed on with the Nets, and he's now wearing it as a badge of honor in many ways.
Well, to think about the fact that he now leads the league in charges and additionally does so on the Nets just with his time yep. here in Brooklyn. But it was those two charges he took the night that I think in some ways shifted the momentum of the game, and those stretches allowed the Nets to open up the floor. And offensively, they can run and initiate so much offense through him, not only because he can score and take advantage of mismatches, but also how he's able to find teammates. We see just great reads of all these guys off one yep. another. And to think about the fact that Mike James played such a significant amount of time after just being signed to a 10-day contract. But it's the roles, it's the fit that I think everyone is able to feed off of and find that type of continuity.
And the Phoenix Suns come to town on Sunday. They've been one of the best teams in the NBA this season. Monty Williams has done outstanding work there. Chris Paul, everywhere he goes, that team wins. That has been fairly consistent throughout his NBA career.
And you imagine this is going to be a hungry, motivated, and relatively rested Phoenix Suns yep. team, despite the fact they're on this road trip. They probably had one of their worst games of the season just the other night at Boston. And so they'll have a couple days and opportunities to prepare for the Nets on Sunday. And you said it's been fun to watch what Phoenix has been able to do. And imagine they will be ready to rebound Sunday.
20 games over 500. The Nets are once again in sole possession of first place in the Eastern Conference. They sweep the Boston Celtics, and they get it done down the stretch.